stations. If you encounter any technical issues related to this live show broadcast, please call our trouble hotline at 336-464-1806. Mark, 2 minutes until airtime for this live show broadcast. Your next time cue will come with 1 minute until airtime on the Rice Sports Network. We're coming up on 1 minute until airtime. 1 minute in 5, 4, 3, 2, mark. 1 minute stations, 1 minute until airtime for this live show broadcast. Studios, when you hear, please start your archive recording. Coming up on 30 seconds until airtime, on my mark. Mark, 30 seconds. Your next and final time cue will be with 15 seconds until airtime. Coming up on 15 seconds until airtime. Mark, 15 seconds, stations. Have fun.
The following is a Learfield presentation of the Rice Sports Network. On the Rice Sports Network from Learfield, live from Acme Oyster House, welcome to the Mike Bloomgren Show. Acme Oyster House, life's more fun with seafood. The Mike Bloomgren Show is brought to you by The Parking Spot. We have airport parking covered. The International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 716, lighting up Rice University and Houston for over 100 years. Now, alongside Coach Bloomgren, here's the voice of the Owls, J.P. Heath.
Yes, 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 we made it back. The Mike Bloomgren Show here at Acme Oyster House, 1201 Westheimer. How about them Rice Owls that win their first ever dub inside the American Athletic Conference? Right on cue, Coach and the folks walking on in as Rice taking down the ECU Pirates this past Saturday, gritty fashion, 24-17. And got a great defensive lineup on the show here this evening. We have DC of our Rice Owls, Brian Smith. We have a linebacker, safety, call him what you want, just call him Play Wyatt. He will be on the extravaganza. And we have Pittsburgh Tough through and through, a hoot with him on the postgame show the other night. So he said, hey, I got to get to Acme. That's a poor Coleman Coco impression, but he will be on coming up here in a matter of moments as well. He had 8 tackles from that defensive end spot. As you probably know, that's not easy to do. But Rice over ECU, a lot of accolades coming out of that one. A very great, I don't know where the superlatives could end with what JT Daniels has done this season, but he's up knocking on the door, 1,500 yards, 13 touchdowns in his first 5 games, his highest total through 5 games. He had Chris Conte, his first career interception, and special teams coming up big as well, too. Rice and UConn coming up on Saturday. That's a 4 o'clock start time, and that's ESPN+. If you'd like to sync us up, you can go to syncmygame.com And we will have the Huskies coming in. They're 0-5 on the season, but as Coach and I will talk about coming in, they are, I know what it sounds like, but sounds like the company line. It is not. They are a very solid 0-5 team. And you look at the teams they played and they lost to, and obviously a great head coach in Jim Mora. The last time he was at Rice was his first game as a collegiate head coach when UCLA came in way back in August of 2012. I remember it well, just like it was yesterday. But a lot to get to. Don't forget, Acme is your spot for some Owls viewing. We want you out at the park at Rice Stadium this week. But here's to Red Beans and Rice University. Acme Oyster House, proud sponsor of our Owls. After the game, come join us for a fried seafood platter, shrimp po' boy, or a dozen char-grilled oysters. Acme, the best little oyster house in Texas. Home here at the Mike Bloomgren Show, Mondays 7 until 8 at 1201 Westheimer. And this is a public service announcement. We want you at Acme the next couple of weeks, but a little asterisk in there. We will not be having a show the next couple weeks. We have the off week next week, and then the quirks of the scheduling, of course, with the bye, and then the Thursday night game the week after that. Like, hey, what do you do here? Carry the five, divide the remainder. Like, how do you add up and make it fit? So we do not have a show that week of the Tulsa game, but we'll be blowing and going for the weeks after that. So the next two Mondays, we do not have shows out here. But thanks to Sydney serving us. She's working hard. Timmy running things back in the kitchen. I've got Walter here pushing the buttons, tweaking the dials, and, of course, Clara back in the studio. And thanks to all of you listening on the Varsity Network app, the Rice Owls Game Day app, riceowls.com. And, hi, there's the back of my hand waving at our YouTube and our social media folks. Lurking in there watching us. We love you lurking and watching in for our Owls. Stay tuned. Coming up next, we will get this thing going. I will talk to Dunleavy Family Head Football Coach Mike Bloomgren. It's the Mike Bloomgren Show here from Acme Oyster House from Learfield.
Football fans are passionate, just like John Deere fans. And if you're a John Deere person, the name to know is Shoppus. In football, it's about calling the right plays. The right call for John Deere equipment is Shoppus. Shoppus has a right-sized John Deere tractor with attachments for any job. You can build your tractor online with Shoppus' exclusive Build It, Price It, Own It tool. See all our John Deere specials by Googling Shoppus at S-H-O-P-P-A-S. It's time for you to make the right call. Shoppus, equipment for your piece of Texas and proud sponsor of Rice Owl Athletics.
Hey, Oscar. Oscar, wake up. Hi, this is Otis and Oscar, the talking spokes oysters for Acme Oyster House. You've probably seen us on TV. My friend Oscar is, sleeping. You know, we oysters like our beds. Anyway, drop by tonight for a dozen raw, a dozen char-grilled, a seafood platter or po' boy, and maybe a few laughs. Come Acme, bro. Not you. Acme Oyster House. Life's more fun with seafood.
Owls fans, you may not think of yourself as an athlete, but everyday life is full of athletic feats. You bend, you reach, you lift, you twist until back, neck, or shoulder pain hits, which brings you to a stop. So whether you're an athlete or not, the Joint Chiropractic can help ease your pain and keep you on the active list. Visit any of our 40-plus Houston area locations or thejoint.com today to get your first consultation, exam, and adjustment for just $29. The Joint Chiropractic, the official chiropractor of Rice University Athletics.
Aw, shucks, the game's on TV, but I can't listen to the call of my favorite team broadcasters.
Never fear, Sync My Game is here.
Sync My Game?
Yes, Sync My Game. If you have a DVR and streaming device, head to SyncMyGame.com from Learfield. It's never been easier to hear the impassioned voices of your favorite radio crew synced with the TV.
Wow, thank you, Mr.
Just remember, SyncMyGame.com.
Highlighting the Owls on the gridiron. Welcome back to the Mike Bloomgren Show.
You know it here with the boss man himself, Dunleavy Family Head Football Coach of our Rice Owls, Mike Bloomgren. The fun is in the winning.
The fun is in the winning, yes.
Quoting you, right?
Yes, sir.
You draw all these great life anecdotes. You get, I don't know what it was. You said, anyway, I like the short, simple Mike Bloomgren phrases. I like to remember them where I can, and I can't, ironically, I can't remember the last one you told me on Saturday, but how about that dub? Like you told Jason after the game, it wouldn't win a beauty pageant, but that doesn't matter one bit. Pretty is pretty, and that was a type of culture-defining win. I know that you love to see those types of wins. What are your thoughts a couple days after?
Yeah, I think you're exactly right, number one. I mean, there was a lot of slop out there, but this is the first time since we've been here where we didn't play excellent, at least on one side of the ball, and found a way to win a game. And so that's a good thing. It speaks to the process that everybody's been through, how hard these players have worked, that, again, even when we're not perfect, as long as we're scrappy and we're gritty and we have that heart throughout the game and we find a way to make plays at the right time, we can win it. Now, we're coaches. We're going to try to clean all that stuff up and put our best foot forward. But it's great to get a win in that situation. I think there were so many good efforts that you'll probably talk about here in a second. But whether you're talking about our defense and the four fourth down stops in the second half, the goal line stand, I mean, those are things that are winning football.
Just their ability to move it inside the 20, but really even almost 5 to 5, the way your defense stood up and stiffened there inside the 10 to 5 yard line, what went into that? Obviously great D-line play, but that seemed to be a big factor in the game.
Yeah, I mean, it was just good defense. When we got into the red zone, we made everything so hard. Even on the touchdown that they scored there, it took them 6 plays to get in from inside the 5, you know, because we were just pounding. And the other thing that made a difference, every time they entered the red zone, it seemed like we got a big play, whether it was Chris Conte's interception or just hitting the passer time and time again. PFF credited us with 31 total pressures. Think our defensive staff had us with 10 quarterback hits and 3 sacks. So that's pretty exciting in and of itself. That makes the guy playing quarterback not quite as effective when he's on his back. So that's great. The offensive stuff was good in that we found a way. We were 3 for 3 in the red zone. We had a great answer there in the fourth quarter on the screen to Landon. So there's some really good things in there. We scored points off a turnover, which is something you always want to do when the defense gets you the ball or a big special teams play. You want to take advantage of those short fields and make sure we turn it into points. So, again, lots to teach off of, but it sure feels better after a win.
Since you just mentioned that touchdown pass to Landon on the screen play, it's one of my favorite plays I've seen. And then going back, looking at the replay, one, his first career touchdown, but the way Clay moved out there on that screen and how he was coming back, hadn't been in the lineup the last couple of days, but diagram that. That was a very, obviously, the biggest touchdown of the game, but the way it took place was just a football beauty, boss.
Yeah, and not for nothing. You know, you got a quarterback that hasn't practiced all week, and he's got weak pressure coming at him. He's able to hang in there on his back foot and make that throw. And Luke was not the most, not his most physical play of the day on his block on the corner, but then Clay does such a great job coming flat like you have to on a screen and takes out the safety, and Landon turns up and does the rest. And Brant Banks, I think, thought he had a great block, but whether it was great or not, it was a human shield. And I don't know if it affected the play, but Brant was really proud of it. So I wanted to bring that up, but everybody doing their job to make sure that ball got in the end zone.
And you mentioned JT. You had number 18, and they didn't. And Dean told us after the game, and he was nice about it. He wasn't patronizing to us, but he says, I don't think y'all don't understand what JT had to come back from to be able to just lace up in that game. So, one, how impressive was the performance, and how much did that show the team from a leadership perspective, just him getting out there with what he had to go through?
Yeah, I think that's exactly right. I think when you show your teammates that you're going to keep fighting for them, and especially at that position when you are, you know, a golden boy, if you will. You know, we put those quarterbacks on such a pedestal, and when he's going to fight through that pain, because everybody on this team's fighting through something right now. You're in week 5, now going into week 6 of the college football season. Nobody's body feels great, you know, and that's the bottom line. And so many guys are fighting through things, and our trainers are doing an outstanding job. I think our strength coaches are doing everything they can to keep the wind in the right place. And then these guys go out and just gut it out. Like, that was really gritty and gutty what JT did. Really proud of him.
And you said before the game, like, you joke sometimes, hey, I might tell you this a lot of games, but you took the ball away from them. Chris Conte, his first career pick, how big was that at that time? But just taking it, snatching it away, because that fueled that ensuing drive.
Yeah, I think it was big in a couple of reasons. They had just gotten another first down, and so, again, they're cracking into the red zone. That turnover, and not just the turnover, but then he gets another, drags the guy another 15 or 20 yards and sets us up at midfield. And what an exciting, you know, again, the juice that it brings to your sideline when you have one of those kind of plays. You just can feel momentum shift over to your sideline, and it's such a good feeling.
Yeah, 3 straight wins to start the home slate for the second consecutive season. And what does that mean, the way you can get that punch, get it early, like you've done most of the time, but really starting to control things there at Rice Stadium?
You know, but this one was a little different, right? Like, we had a play on the second play of the game that I thought Coach Tuiasosopo did a great job designing. It was right there, and 18 misses it. He hits that pass 999 times out of 1,000, you know. And, again, that's when it was like, okay, we all got to calm down, and we got to get him in rhythm. And then once he did, that was great. And then we talked again about the defense in the second half. Like, and you need everything. Everything's got to work. Everybody's got to do their job so you find a way to score one more point, because at the end of the day, that is the goal. And so it's awesome to be 3-0 at home. It's exciting to have another home game this week.
What have you seen from the guys? I know after that week, it's always a fun winning locker room, but how bouncing back from a loss, but getting that first ever win in American Athletic Conference play and taking this momentum. I know you're just worrying about UConn, but how that could bolster the guys through this middle portion of the schedule here.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing we talked about, yes, that's a big win to get that first conference dub. It was awesome to do it in those unis, which won uni swag uniform of the week. I don't know if you saw that, JP, on nice. Twitter, but that's big time stuff for Chris Snell and our equipment department. But it's the ultimate, like, look good, feel good, play good, right? And so I love that aspect. And there's just a lot of cool things about that game, but that's the result. We know that we've got to improve so many things. And so you come into those meetings today with great focus, and then you talk about this, the celebration that happened in the locker room, but you also move forward really quickly, because whether it's good poop or bad poop, you got to flush it, and you got to move on to the next thing. And that's what we talked about in the meeting today. We've got to move forward and get our process going, because that's all that matters, is going 1-0 this week.
All right, you can make me write that one down here.
Yeah, sorry, that's a Tallahasseeism probably too. Sorry,
okay,
I got a few of those.
I guess I'd heard that in a way. But you also told me before the game how you called Wade Phillips getting the permission to wear the hat in tribute to Bum, and just take us through that whole process, because that was a really cool deal with the Love You Blue jerseys, and how the guys, obviously, I mean, all ages liked it, but it particularly hit that chord with the students and the fans there.
Yeah, so your boy Cedric Calhoun, when he was doing an internship in the NFL with the Chargers, it was under Wade, so they'd become very close. And Wade comes around our building several times a year. He comes to spring ball and just stands off to the side. Sometimes he'll come and talk ball with us. But the story he told one day was, like, why a seven technique is called a seven technique. And it's always been credited to Bear Bryant. Everybody said there was a bunch of bourbon involved. But Wade kind of took us back, and he was like, actually, that was my dad that called it a seven technique, because it was inside shade of the tight end, and we wanted to make sure everybody understood it as this and what the responsibility was to end in that alignment. And I was just blown away. I mean, I'm a football historian. I love all that stuff. And so, again, now we're wearing these as a tribute to this team, to the Houston Oilers. But I thought, like, let's make it bigger. Let's make it about, like, also the connection to this great city, and also the connection to football that's come out of this city with Bum. And that's what I remember. When I remember watching the Oilers wear those Love You Blues, man, it was Bum on the sideline. Like, that's what I remember. And I remember him wearing that cowboy hat at all their away games, and wouldn't wear it in the dome because Mama wouldn't like it.
And to be able to get that with, speaking of the defense, you hit on the defense earlier. How about the guys getting behind the line of scrimmage? You're 18th nationally, third in the conference with over seven tackles for loss. And that went a lot into that last game, but that's not the first game or the last probably that they made that type of change.
No, I think what we're doing at the line of scrimmage is awesome. I think the movement we're getting, the penetration we're getting, and also the effort that we're playing at. That's a lot of times what a head coach will tell me from the other team when we talk after the game or a couple days later. He'll be like, man, your D-line, man, they were just so relentless. And that makes everybody's job better. We always talk about how rush and coverage work together and the run fits. Like, it's their ability to, you know, hold their point and then, again, reverse Delnicki, as they call it, to get to the other side of it. And then it makes it easier for guys like Play and those linebackers to fit. I thought Chris Conte had a great game. All these guys are playing like their hair's on fire. And that's what you got to have on that defensive side of the ball. That passion and that desire to play great for each other is what makes it magical over there.
Let's talk about the players up. First, a member of that D-line, Coleman Coco, big, tough Pittsburgh guy coming in from Colgate, and the impact he's made has been very evident.
Yeah, the definition of blue collar, man. Like, we'll see if he can make it through my Tuesday practice tomorrow. That'll be the biggest test of if he's as tough as we say he is. But, no, his mindset, his attitude, the way he He's so passionate about our game. And I think he makes everybody around him play better. And, you know, you often talk about that with a quarterback or somebody like that. But he's a guy that just brings that juice. And I really appreciate him. He stepped into this locker room like he's been here forever. And that's been a lot of fun. I think he's been accepted really well, but also he's made an impact. And that's hard to do in your first year.
And how about the versatility? You got Play Wyatt, who's stepping in for a veteran, and Trayshawn Chamberlain. And what Play's done is up there. I didn't see the updated leading tacklers, but he's been up there 1-2 this season in leading you in tackles.
Yeah, he's doing a great job because there's so much that's asked of that Viper position, you know, and he's playing a lot of different roles for us, different fits, different assignments, play to play. And then he's also doing a lot of things for us on special teams, you know. So, again, you can't underestimate his value. And really excited about the growth that Play's had. You know, he came in here as a little wet behind the ears, but he's pretty good right now.
All right, Coach, thanks.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Dunleavy Family Head Football Coach of Rice Owls, Mike Blomgren. We're not flushing this show, though, till it's over, right?
Till it's over.
That's what we're doing. Okay, gotcha. I just want to get it all lined up. Stay tuned. Coming up next, the aforementioned Pittsburgh tough guy, Coleman Koga. He'll join us at the high table. It's a Mike Blomgren show live at Acme Oyster House from Learfield.
Flight by Yuengling, the next generation of light beer for those who don't follow trends, but craft them. Flight by Yuengling is uncompromised refreshment from America's oldest brewery. With only 2.6 grams of carbs and 95 calories, this is premium refreshment. Six generations in the making. Don't just raise a glass, raise the bar. Flight by Yuengling, the official beer partner of Rice Athletics, and now available for purchase everywhere in Texas. The Yuengling Company, Fort Worth, Texas. Please enjoy responsibly.
The passion.
He's going to take it to the house. Dinner's cooking. Touchdown.
The fury.
Getting blitzed. Down he goes.
The speed.
To the 40. There he goes. Down the sideline.
Western College football.
Toward the end zone. Got it for 6 points.
You cannot hitch the wagon. Put the ponies in the board.
Back to the end zone.
30. 20.
This is the College Football Blitz. Listen all season long on College Sports Now on the Varsity Network.
What if a world-leading hospital could also be your neighborhood doctor's office? With Houston Methodist, it is. Our primary care physicians invest time in your visit so you're seen and heard, virtually and in person at locations across the city. And we're always ready to connect you with our network of top specialists. To learn more, visit HoustonMethodist.org.
Houston Methodist, leading medicine.
Which schools will take home the prestigious Learfield Directors Cup for the 2023-24 college athletic season? You can follow the standings of your favorite school or alma mater at L Directors Cup on Twitter and online at TheDirectorsCup.com. That's TheDirectorsCup.com and L Directors Cup on Twitter. Trophies will be awarded in June 2024 to the winning institutions in all competitive divisions. Learfield Directors Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics.
Rice teams and traditions are legendary. Our team as strategic wealth designers are proud to be a partner of Rice Athletics. What an honor to be working together. When you're ready to discuss your financial future, call the team the Owls Trust. We look forward to creating your winning strategy for retirement. Visit us at swdgroup.com today and go Owls.
This is the Mike Blomgren Show, live at Acme Oyster House. Here again, the voice of the Owls, J.P. Heath.
You know it. We're back here at Acme Oyster House here. We can get some great po' boys, some great shrimp. I know y'all are wondering. I forgot to mention this. Our first segment, I had some meat pies. Walter snatched a few of those char-grilled oysters away from me. Bob did too. And I've got I'm just eating it all, basically. What do we have? We have the po' boy and some gumbo after. So a wide selection there. Stay tuned in just a sec. We talk some more Owls defense with Play Wyatt and then D.C. Brian Smith. But join now. Now by a guy that said, I got to come. He told me after the game, hey, what's up? I got to give me some oysters. It is the one and only Coleman Koga. How are you doing, good man?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, so take us through. I really respected after the game. You're like, hey, what's up? Like we were talking during the commercial break. So you go to Sydney. You're like, hey, I need some oysters. And after having an 8 or 9 tackle game, I guess that's the time to make that shout out, huh?
Yeah, I guess I'm a cheap date. So, yeah, it was pretty easy. It was just like,
you guys going to talk to me. I got to bring me in for the oysters and the dinner. But no, it's great. So I just wanted to see if you guys would have me, and awesome to be here.
Yeah, of course. What's on the menu? What you chowing down on?
I literally ate everything already. So
okay.
I ate some of the oysters, and then I had like the oyster tacos as well. Great. Awesome.
So before the show interrupted our show during the break there, you're telling me Pittsburgh actually has a couple good seafood places, and me as the Texan, I wouldn't think Pittsburgh would be that kind of city, but you got some.
I mean, it's got everything. Pittsburgh is a great city for food, for sure. Like Italian food and stuff like that. But, you know, a lobster roll guy, I can get a little bit of sushi going. You know, I'll eat anything, really.
Okay.
Honestly, yeah.
Well, speaking of that, what's your favorite pregame meal? Like, if you had to pick or plan the menu?
I think we do a great job, like, honestly, here.
Of course.
I've had some pregame meals in the past that are a little bit skeptical, but but no, here we get treated great. So we got, like, some steak and some potatoes and, like, quick carbs, you know, get it going, pasta, that kind of stuff. Tackling fuel, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh.
And you've been doing a lot of that. Speak to the game on Saturday. I guess that's the first half one, but you had – no, there you are. Yeah, 8 tackles on the game there. Yep. 1.5 behind the line of scrimmage. Just one of your better games. And what went into that? The strong D-line play and y'all's ability to get after the passer, I'd imagine, too.
Yeah, I think that the 8 tackles just happens. I mean, we just play as hard as we can, and those numbers just pop up. And I think the D-line that we have is so talented, and the defense that we have is so talented. And I've said it before for people that have asked me, like, I'm very lucky to just fall into play sometimes. I've got Isaiah and DB and Piercy and all kinds of guys that are super talented at what they do. And oftentimes I just find the quarterback or the running back just sitting right in front of me, like on a platter. So it's great to have guys like that are able to make it so easy for me to do and have stat lines like that.
So you're all Patriot League a couple years at Colgate. And when you knew you'd be going somewhere, take us through the process coming to Rice and what eventually won out for coming to Rice.
Yeah, so once I graduated, my clock to play in the Patriot League expired, so I had to move forward and transfer. But really, it came down to the idea that I wanted to further my education, get my master's, and also play at a big-time program. And, I mean, where else would I rather play than Rice? I mean, awesome. Like, I'm in the MBA program along with all the other D linemen as well that are starters. It's pretty sweet. But awesome academics and the football stuff that they got going on here. I think we're proving to people that we're a little bit of a football school now. I think people are starting to understand that. But no, the coaches right from the get-go. I mean, Coach Calhoun flew out the day that he talked to me, and he was like sitting down at lunch with me the next day talking about what he had going on. And so even just that interaction that I had, you know, I wasn't an 18-year-old going into the portal. Like, I wasn't looking for the flashy jersey or the locker room. I was, like, trying to go somewhere that was about their business and where I'd, like, mesh in pretty well. And Coach Calhoun and Coach Bloom and Coach Smith had all, like, straight and narrow on what their plan was, and I was all on board.
Well, it's interesting you mentioned Coach Calhoun, because when he was up here, I asked him open-ended, I was like, who's the baddest dude on the D-line? And he mentioned you. So discuss that relationship you've built with him and why he might say something like that.
I mean, I'll say that he's the best coach I've ever had. He's awesome. Like, he not only is he just a genius in the film room and out as a coach, he's like, honestly, like a father to me, like in a lot of ways. He's just great. You can just interact with him and be so comfortable with him. And he, the environment that he brings, like, he's sent so many guys to the NFL, but he's such a great guy. Like, he's a great coach. And I'm so lucky to have him coach me every day and be there for every day with him. And, but yeah, now for him to say that, that's pretty sweet. Like I said to you, he's a bad dude too. So he's a bad dude to call you a bad dude. That's real stuff. So.
Game recognized game.
Exactly. Yeah.
You also told us on the post game how the adjustment here has been easy, not as far as the work, but as far as the assimilation. So kind of give it for the audience that wasn't by the channel there, how you've been able to come in and make it look easier than I know it actually is.
Yeah. Now, right away, all the guys are so inviting to just, they are like ready to have guys that are ready to win around them, right? Whether it's me, JT, Lavelle Dumont, Brant Banks, all kinds of guys that just were able to jump in and mesh right away with these guys super well, because we all had the same mindset that all these guys have been working and working for. And so, yeah, to just come in and meet some of these guys. And like I said, these guys are like going to be friends for life for me. I've met a lot of great guys here. And yeah, no, it was super easy. Obviously, like transferring, you're a little nervous. Like, you're going to have a friend group. You're going to meet all kinds of guys. But like, really, even more than I thought, I've met and gotten along with so many guys here. It's great. Yeah.
A lot of study groups with all y'all in the NBA.
Tons of studying. Yep. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So any favorite class or two that you've stuck out to you?
So the MBA program is starting this week.
Okay.
So I'm starting my first class tomorrow. So I haven't even taken a class in the MBA yet, but it's getting started, and the quadmaster starts tomorrow.
That's right. So all ball up until now.
I've been pretty lucky. Yeah.
Gets real with the books.
Uh-huh.
So take us through growing up. Did you always play D-line, or like Josh Piercy told us a few weeks ago, he was water boy. He was the quarterback. He was running. He was safe. Like,
he's lying to you. He was the water boy. So I played middle linebacker in high school. I played inside linebacker like a zero and just kind of played A-to-A and filled the gaps there. But I was like 240 pounds, 235 pounds, and it's tough to get recruited as an inside linebacker at that weight. And so I kind of slipped down to the D-line my senior year and tried to just put a little bit of film out there showing that I have a little bit of versatility. Picked up a couple offers, some Patriot League offers, a couple like MAC offers, but nothing crazy. So the decision to go play in the Patriot League was from just kind of playing like that type of position. Like, I still was kind of like filling into my body a little bit, I think. So, yeah, as a younger guy, I did. I played that middle linebacker and like H-back, and, like, tight end, yeah.
Favorite thing about Houston in these months since coming down here from Big Pittsburgh, or I guess Colgate, but from Pittsburgh too?
Not the heat. I'll tell you that. It's so different. There's some days I think I'm going to melt out here. Like,
we think that too, if that makes you feel better.
Yeah, we'll practice outside, and I'll act as tough as I can, but it can get you crazy. But my favorite thing, I gotta say, being able to just golf all year round, right? I'm lucky. Like, I haven't really had the opportunity to, but being able to do that, and then also there's good food everywhere. Yeah, like the Hamilton, the town was smaller than the university. So
in Colgate, right?
Yeah, exactly. So we had like a Dunkin' Donuts and a McDonald's, and those are like the two places you could eat. And now it's like I could eat anywhere that I want. It's pretty sweet.
You're telling me I can get oysters here and here.
Yeah,
and here,
right.
Okay. Favorite player or two growing up? Some Steelers or like trying to buff up on your position? Did you model game after anybody else?
No, I was definitely a Steelers guy, but I was a big Ray Lewis guy. Ray Lewis guy. He's baddest ever. Big Brian Urlacher guy. And my favorite Steeler, though, I was always a Brett Kiesel guy. Yeah, at defensive end, too, the beard. So, sweet, for sure. Like, I always was just Steelers fan. My dad and my family are big Steelers fans. So, yeah, watch
that
a lot. You
know. Steelers going to get it together here?
Probably not.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
We root for Boz there.
For sure.
We've known Chris Boswell forever and a day.
He's good. He's doing his job.
He can kick it through the pipes.
For sure.
Hey, thanks for what you've done on the field this year, and it's been great having you up here and getting to know you. And we appreciate it. Thank you much.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
The bad dude, Coleman Coco.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much. Stay tuned. Coming up next, we'll stick on the defensive side of the ball. Play Wild will join us here at the high table. It's the Mike Bloomgren Show live from Learfield.
Big trip on the horizon? Before you depart, you gotta park. The parking spot is a simpler, easier way to navigate airport parking, and you can save when you book online. You're guaranteed a spot, and we even pick you up at your trunk in our yellow and black spotted shuttles and take you straight to the terminal. Parking and saving come full circle at the parking spot. The parking spot, proud sponsor of Rice University. Visit theparkingspot.com to reserve your spot today.
Shoppus has the right John Deere for your piece of Texas. If you're looking for a tractor, gator, or lawnmower, let the experts at Shoppus give you the right answers to your John Deere questions. Shoppus makes buying a piece of John Deere equipment easy with our online Build It, Price It, Own It tool. You can add attachments specific to your needs or check out our ready-to-go John Deere tractor packages. See all that Shoppus has to offer by Googling Shoppus at S-H-O-P-P-A-S. Shoppus, equipment for your piece of Texas, and proud sponsors of Rice Owl Athletics.
Aw, shucks. The game's on TV, but I can't listen to the call of my favorite team broadcasters.
Never fear. Sync My Game is here.
Sync My Game?
Yes, Sync My Game. If you have a DVR and streaming device, head to SyncMyGame.com from Learfield. It's never been easier to hear the impassioned voices of your favorite radio crew synced with the TV.
Wow, thank you, Mr.
Just remember, SyncMyGame.com.
Owls fans, you may not think of yourself as an athlete, but everyday life is full of athletic feats. You bend, you reach, you lift, you twist until back, neck, or shoulder pain hits, which brings you to a stop. So whether you're an athlete or not, the Joint Chiropractic can help ease your pain and keep you on the active list. Visit any of our 40-plus Houston area locations or thejoint.com today to get your first consultation, exam, and adjustment for just $29. The Joint Chiropractic, the official chiropractor of Rice University Athletics.
You're listening to the latest on Owls football with the head coach, Mike Blumgren. Now, let's go back inside Acme Oyster House.
Yes, yes. Coach and I will talk about Jim Mora's Huskies coming up here later. We also have defensive coordinator Brian Smith joining us next segment. Right now, number 41 on your Rice Owls roster, it is Play Wyatt. How are you doing, good man?
I'm doing good. How about yourself?
Outstanding. Thanks for coming on.
Yes, sir.
We appreciate it. We see in the, they give us all these notes and this info, and they got Viper. And for those that don't know what a Viper is, kind of explain your role, how Coach mentioned in his first segment, how you do a lot of different things out there.
Basically, like it's like a Sam nickel linebacker. I can be high, playing cover one. I can be in the box. I can be, you know, coming off the edge, coming through the A-gap. So really, really everything, D-line, you know, middle linebacker, you know, safety. So everything kind of all in one position.
Yeah, did you learn a lot from Trayshawn last year?
Yeah, I learned a lot. You know, just going through the years and having someone like him, like a leader on the defense, just seeing how he played and just seeing the type of player he was, it's kind of motivating me, you know what I'm saying, taking the steps behind him and just learning from him and growing. So I really appreciate that.
Like I asked Coleman in his segment with you, did you always play defense, or are you on the other side of the ball at times too? Or
I played defense. I play offense too. I play quarterback, running back. My junior year, I played a lot of quarterback, running back. They don't know, but I play kick return, punt return, took some kick return, punt return to the house, but I retired from that, so just safety now.
For the McKinney Boyd Broncos up there in the Metroplex, take us your third year at Rice now, right?
Yes, sir.
So take us through that path coming here, and obviously good on the books, but what led you to Rice?
I had a good coach, head coach, in my junior year of high school at Bishop Lynch, and he knew one of our old coaches that used to coach at Rice, and they kind of connected me, and I kind of just fell in love with the city. It was close to home, and all the coaching staff, it was just the love was there, you know what I'm saying, and I really appreciated it. So When they told me, like, they had offered me, I think a couple weeks later, I committed because I was, you know, I was ready to come play. So, yeah, I really appreciate, you know, them taking a chance on me for real.
What other sports did you like playing?
In high school, I had played basketball. In my senior year, I ran a 4x4 on track, ran a 400 too. We were supposed to win state in a 4x4, but, you know, COVID happened. Got shut down the whole thing.
Oh,
yeah, messed up my chance to win a state championship. Yeah.
So, did COVID glad you reminded me that COVID didn't affect any path coming here, right? Like you kind of knew going in there, or that was that connection you said that was made?
Yeah, as soon as I committed my junior year, and then it was it from there. I was locked in. I was ready to go. Yeah, I kind of helped recruit some more people from the 2020 class, and we were just locked in, ready to get to the point we're at now.
Yeah, you talked about you being a basketball player. I remember it might have been your true freshman year. Your brother got to play. Maybe it was a couple different times. Your brother actually plays for Jarvis Christian. Is he still play there?
He don't play there no more, but okay. He did play Rice, I think, one or two times. He put up buckets on him.
Yeah.
But they didn't get the win, but he had about like 20, 30 points on him.
So. I remember that game because I saw you there, and I kept saying, that's Play Wyatt's brother. So you teach him how to get buckets. I guess was he a little older than you?
Yeah, he was probably like 4 or 5 years older than me, but he always been there. That's what he do. I ain't gonna lie. Basketball in his blood, so he got me in that sport.
So take us through the defense and what you've seen, the maturation, how we saw this last game. Coach talked about it being a big blue-collar game. What have you, even though you're a first-year starter, you've been around it for a while. What have you seen from this year's defense that you've liked?
I feel like so far it's been a lot of growth. Going into the season, I know for sure the back end, the safety group was, it only had one player who really had that much play time, which is Gabe. He really been taking that leader role, taking me, Marcus, JoJo, you know, everybody to just step up. And I feel like it's been a lot of maturity. Learning from Coach Smith, you know, he always harp on just doing your job, do your 111. And I had to hear about that. He was on me last the USF game about doing my job. But I feel like we all just learning and growing, and we're just trying to see how far we can get to.
Would you rather have a pick six or a scoop and a score?
I feel like a pick six cool. I had a pick six in the fall scrimmage. I had a little celebration, but I can't do that in the game. They're going to get a flag, so I feel like that would be cool.
So either one of them, but, yeah. Or just the pick six?
I'll take both of them. I can't lie.
However you can help the team, right?
Yes, sir.
Take us through your – you said how unique your position is, but the other guys in that unit, how y'all have gelled too.
Yeah, we really came together. We really a lot of team bonding. I feel like growing up, going through the program, this is the guys, like, you know, we got the 2020 class and the 2021 class. So this is like kind of the safeties in the room now. So we had 2-3 years to just gel and bond. So now I look around and see, you know, Marcus, JoJo, Gabe, see the corners, Trey D and Sean. And I'd like, them, like the brothers, like, I came in with, you know, we had tough years with, but this year we finally feel like this is the year that we're going to explode.
So is Coleman the baddest dude on the team or just his line or who is if not?
Not gonna lie, Coco hard. Yeah, he hard, man. I feel like he's a tough act to follow.
Okay.
Yeah.
What classes do you like? What are you studying and what have you liked so far? I've been around a bit, but what have you liked so far?
I'm finna major in sports management. I'm a graduate in the spring.
Nice.
But my favorite class right now, probably I got a business class I really like. She be talking a lot of business marketing and like how to market your brand and how to market, like, you know, whatever you're a part of. So I like that. I like attending that class.
Okay. Cowboys fan growing up, since so close to there or not?
No, sir. Never been a Cowboys fan.
Okay.
Yeah, I've always been a Ravens fan. Like you said, Ray Lewis, Ed Reed. I've never been a Cowboys fan. I don't never liked the Cowboys.
Well, I mean, there's a lot of other guys I've asked different sports. Like, they just didn't take to it. So you're not offended any other Cowboys fan.
Yeah, but. Nah. They head too big, man. Never going to win.
Tell me about it. Don't get me started. Tell us about keys for the rest of the season. What you guys, you're almost at that halfway point, and I know you're looking at just this game, but what do you see as either some improvements or things to stress the rest of the season?
I think things to stress is just staying head level. Really, like I had already mentioned, just, you know, doing your job, you know, doing what you're coached to do, trusting the coaches, and just going out there playing. The things that they set in place, you know, they take hours, you know, film watching, so they know what we need to do to be successful. And that's really all we got to do is just stay on that right path, just stay on the path we're going to, and we should be good.
Hey, thanks for the time, Clay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much. The Clay Wyatt joining us. Stay tuned. Coming up next, we'll have defensive coordinator Brian Smith here at the high table. This is the Mike Bloomgren Show from Acme Oyster House live from Learfield.
Hey, Oscar, wake up. Hi, this is Otis and Oscar, the talking spokes oysters for Acme Oyster House. You've probably seen us on TV. My friend Oscar is, sleeping. You know, we oysters like our beds. Anyway, drop by tonight for a dozen raw, a dozen char-grilled, a seafood platter or po' boy, and maybe a few laughs. Come Acme, bro. Not you. Acme Oyster House. Life's more fun with seafood.
At True Anomaly Brewing, our greatest achievement lives in knowing that everything we've learned is yours to enjoy. While it may not be rocket science, we brew with the same detail and dedication learned while running mission operations for NASA. Taking risks is part of our DNA. We don't take them just to say we did, we take them because of the result. Bold brews we're proud to share with fellow adventure seekers. True Anomaly Brewing, beer for the explorers.
The newly renovated Houston Marriott Medical Center Museum District is a proud new sponsor of Rice University Athletics. For visiting families and fans, the closest hotel to Rice University is delighted to offer preferred rates. Guests will enjoy two new restaurants, a new exclusive M Club lounge, and complimentary shuttle service within 2 miles of the hotel. Visit Marriott.com to learn more.
The passion.
He's going to take it to the house. Dinner's cooking. Touchdown.
The fury.
Getting blitzed. Down he goes.
The speed.
To the 40. There he goes. The other sideline.
Western College football.
Toward the end zone. Got it for 6 points.
You cannot hitch the wagon. Put the pony to the board.
Back to the end zone.
30. 20.
This is the College Football Blitz. Listen all season long on College Sports Now on the Varsity Network.
Schools will take home the prestigious Learfield Director's Cup for the 2023-24 college athletic season. You can follow the standings of your favorite school or alma mater at LDirector's Cup on Twitter and online at TheDirectorsCup.com. That's TheDirectorsCup.com and LDirector's Cup on Twitter. Trophies will be awarded in June 2024 to the winning institutions in all competitive divisions. Learfield Director's Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics.
Highlighting the Owls on the gridiron. Welcome back to the Mike Bloomgren Show.
You know it, back at it here, the Mike Bloomgren Show. Remember, we're not here the next two Mondays, but every Monday after that here, 7 until 8 p.m., we have some Rice football talk. Coach and I talk about those Huskies here in just a smidge. But right now, it is sixth-year defensive coordinator Brian Smith. How the time flies, huh?
Goes by really fast.
Yeah, does it seem like six?
Does not. Seems like we just got here yesterday. I mean, it's really flown by.
Yeah, the team, the defense really has your identity, and they've improved so much year by year. There's different wrinkles, and obviously a lot of new guys rotating in there. What have you liked about this unit, not just this past week, the way they really stepped up and had a big deal to do with the game, but just year to year, the way they progressed?
Yeah, I just like how hard the guys play. You know, doesn't matter what the score is, what the situation. Guys are flying around and playing fast, and it's a good group of kids, and they've got good bonds and good friendships, and they play for each other.
Yeah. So. Yeah, Chuck gave us a stat that y'all are top 20 nationally in tackles for a loss and third in the conference. What does it do when you can get that pressure? I think I know most of that answer, but to be able to consistently get behind the line and make plays seems to have been a big identity for you.
Yeah, I mean, that's huge. You know, Coach talked about it earlier, the D-line, when they can play on the other side of the line of scrimmage and get knock them back, put pressure on the quarterback and get minus yardage plays and put the other team behind the sticks and force them to third and longer situations. You know, makes us a better defense. So Coach Calhoun's done a great job with those guys, getting them to play hard. And we got some dogs up front.
Yeah, what do you think they've taken to the most that you all have preached to them here, just not just from the offseason, but as the weeks go on here? What do you think they've taken to the most?
I mean, Coach Bloom talks a lot about it all the time, just process, you know, taking one day at a time, getting better every day, and, you know, living in the moment. And I think they've done a good job, you know, focusing, and, you know, it never stops. It's a never-ending battle, so the challenge is always, you know, you can play good defense one week, and then the next week, you know, not so good. You can stink it up. So the challenge is every day to get better, and I think they've embraced it so far, and we got to continue to embrace it.
We talked a lot about Coleman and his line. Tell us about the rest of the line there, how it's not just the one deep, but you all are pretty deep in that rotation there.
Yeah, I mean, Josh Piercy, you know, you had him on the show, I guess, earlier in the year. He's done a great job just, you know, being a leader and a veteran up front. You know, he and DeBraylon Carroll, who I think is back now to the level that he was before his injury. He's you know, always been disruptive and playing on the other side of the line. So those two guys have done a really nice job. Isaiah Floyd, you know, he's a team captain and a leader up front. You know, Blake Banish coming off the bench gives us depth, and he's another guy that plays on the other side of the line of scrimmage. And then we've been rotating in some younger guys that have been getting some time, you know, Damone Green and some other guys, so L. Royal Morris. But it's a really deep group, and, you know, it's a good balance of older guys and young guys, and, you know, just working on getting better every day.
You work a lot with the safeties, too. How about that position switch? JoJo Jean comes in and plays safety, and you've done a lot, and then had the game-winning PBU against U of H, but you got Gabriel back there too, and he's put on a lot of good tape in the past, not just this season. So speak to those safeties, how deep you are back there.
Yeah, I think JoJo, you know, at first he wasn't too confident about the move. He wanted to play corner, but he picked it up so fast, and he's done a good job, you know, with the communication part of it. I always thought it would be a good position for him just with his ability, but you know, the communication and seeing things is a little bit different if you've never done it. But he's embraced it and worked hard and really happy with the growth that he's had and excited to see, you know, how he's going to progress. And then Gabe, you know, Play talked about it earlier, you know, from a leadership standpoint, I think he's grown and matured and taken more of a leadership role. And, and guys are learning from him, and you know, he's got to continue to improve like he has. And I thought he played probably his best game last week. It was an improvement from the week before, and you know, I'm just excited on how he's growing and gotten better. And then, you know, obviously you just talked to play. He took a big jump. I was pretty hard on him last week, like he said. Maybe I need to be hard on him again so he can come out and play like he did. But I thought he had a really solid game this week. So, like I said, the challenge is do it again, you know.
Yeah, this goes for other sports. Is it? I mean, sometimes it's easy, you know, what button to push. But other times it's tough to find what touches different guys too. When you too hard, too soft, sometimes it's different for different guys.
Yeah, everybody's different. You know, that's the biggest part of coaching, just learning, you know, what makes guys tick and how you can affect them and help them go places that they couldn't go on their own. So, you know, everybody kind of responds to it differently.
Yeah, I was refreshing myself on your bio going back to the UMass days. I know we've talked in the past about your coaching influence by Don Brown. So who are some other people? And I guess, hey, you answer it how you want to. How did he form you, and who are some other people that have shaped your coaching trajectory, so to speak?
Yeah, I mean, he got me wanting to be a coach. You know, I wasn't a coach coming out of college, but he kind of planted the seed in my mind, and just how you know, infectious he is. He makes other guys want to play the game and play it aggressive and play it the right way. He's probably had the biggest influence just overall, along with my high school coach George Kasanovich back in Bloomington, Delaware. Both of those guys really tough nosed, defensive type coaches, and like I said, made me want to get into coaching, and you know, they probably had the biggest impact. You know, obviously Rex Ryan has had a big impact just in terms of what we do, you know, from a philosophical standpoint, and how he's able to manage different guys and get guys to play hard, and you know, had a ton of influence. Chip Kelly is another guy, kind of, you know, learn how to simplify things as far as how you teach it and group things in boxes so guys can learn, you know, differently. And then, you know, Jim Harbaugh is another guy who you get better at football by playing football. So, you know, another thing that you'll hear Coach Bloom say all the time, but just high reps, you know, getting those reps in, you know, doing it so many times that it makes it hard to mess up, you know, that philosophy. So, you know, learn a lot from different coaches, and you know, you take a little bit from everybody and try to incorporate into your own philosophy and be yourself.
Yeah, and then someday somebody will be saying, hey, yeah, Brian Smith, I was in the Brian Smith tree, all that good stuff, right?
I don't know about that.
Finally, you got UConn. You mentioned being from Delaware. I was doing the charts last night. You got a lot of Delaware guys mixed in on that UConn roster. And tell us a little bit, just an overview on that UConn offense, what you all have seen and how they've had to make a quarterback switch because of injury, but still really good running game and some solid line play too.
Yeah, they do have a really good running game. They're playing with a couple different backs, a lot of outside zone stretch running game, and then they'll run play action off of it, you know, try to throw the ball down the field. They do a good job mixing up the quarterback launch point so you don't know exactly where he's going to be. And, you know, some similarities to our offense, the quarterback, starting quarterback, he actually was teammates with Chris Conte. So we got to, you know, make sure he's not giving them anything on the game plan. But, no, they do a good job mixing it up and running the ball, and they're physical. So we definitely got our hands full this week.
Hey, thanks for all the wisdom and the time off mic, and thanks for coming here tonight. Appreciate it.
All right.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Brian Smith of our Rice Owls. Stay tuned. Coming up next, we'll talk more about those Huskies with Coach Blomgren. This is the Mike Blomgren Show live from Acme Oyster House from Learfield.
Flight by Yuengling, the next generation of light beer for those who don't follow trends but craft them. Flight by Yuengling is uncompromised refreshment from America's oldest brewery. With only 2.6 grams of carbs and 95 calories, this is premium refreshment. Six generations in the making. Don't just raise a glass, raise the bar. Flight by Yuengling, the official beer partner of Rice Athletics, and now available for purchase everywhere in Texas. The Yuengling Company, Fort Worth, Texas. Please enjoy responsibly.
Big trip on the horizon? Before you depart, you gotta park. The parking spot is a simpler, easier way to navigate airport parking, and you can save when you book online. You're guaranteed a spot, and we even pick you up at your trunk in our yellow and black spotted shuttles and take you straight to the terminal. Parking and saving come full circle at the parking spot. The parking spot, proud sponsor of Rice University. Visit theparkingspot.com to reserve your spot today.
Rice teams and traditions are legendary. RTMS Strategic Wealth Designers are proud to be a partner of Rice Athletics. What an honor to be working together. When you're ready to discuss your financial future, call the team the Owls Trust. We look forward to creating your winning strategy for retirement. Visit us at swdgroup.com today. And go Owls!
Football fans are passionate, just like John Deere fans. And if you're a John Deere person, the name to know is Shoppus. In football, it's about calling the right plays. The right call for John Deere equipment is Shoppus. Shoppus has a right-sized John Deere tractor with attachments for any job. You can build your tractor online with Shoppus' exclusive Build It, Price It, Own It tool. See all our John Deere specials by Googling Shoppus at S-H-O-P-P-A-S. It's time for you to make the right call. Shoppus, equipment for your piece of Texas, and proud sponsor of Rice Owl Athletics.
This is the Mike Bloomgren Show, live at Acme Oyster House. Here again, the voice of the Owls, J.P. Heath.
Thank you so much to all of our fans that come out each and every week. Looking at those UConn Huskies and head coach Jim Mora here in a matter of moments, but how about that? At group tonight, Nate calls Coach Smith the silent assassin.
He is.
And you have Coleman in play out there. They did an outstanding job here at the high table.
Yeah, I think it's so cool listening to Brian talk and listen to his pedigree. I mean, he just named like a laundry list of who's who as head coaches, right, and defensive coordinators. It's crazy. But I think back, like, you listen to Brian talk and, you know, you talk about the UMass education. And he is so not like, well, most of our coaches aren't the stereotypical football coach that's going to grab their crotch and spit tobacco, right? Like, these are well-educated people. He went to UMass and was an accountant. And then he was like, he just missed ball so much that he came back, you know, after his tenure in the NFL as a player. It's like Dan Gritty last week talking about, like, well, I was a lawyer on Wall Street and I wanted to get back to football. And I mean, that's what we got. We got a bunch of junkies that actually could be doing so many different things. And it's just so fun to have them around. We're all so lucky to have Coach Smith on our staff and running our defense. And then these other two yahoos that talked, there's some great recruiting stories. Like Coleman Coco, I really ended it with him like two different times on the phone because he wouldn't come visit because he had to take somebody to Canada or something. And I was like, and finally Coach Calhoun was like, Coach, I promise he's coming. I was like, no, nobody's coming in the portal era if they don't see it. And they were both like, yes, he's coming. And he promised me he was coming. I was like, okay, I'm going to kill you if you don't come. So thank God he's here. And thank God he's been, gosh, every bit as good as advertised. And then Play Wyatt, man, like he really was the bell cow of that 2020 class, which was really when our recruiting started to ascend. And he's helped every year since. And gosh, I just can't tell you how thankful I am to have him. And he's also one of those 2020 babies that came in, as he mentioned, under COVID. And it was such a tough time to be a freshman. It's never easy to be a freshman. It's never easy to go through COVID. To do both was horrific for a lot of those kids. And here he has come out the other side and has his girlfriend beside him and looks really happy. And she puts up with a lot. So God bless her, too.
So let's talk about Coach Morris Cub coming in at 0-5. But I will tell you, which you already know, but educate the masses if they don't. They lost to a really good NC State team, Georgia State, Sun Belt, good squad, FIU, a lot better, Duke, nationally ranked, Utah State by just a point. So, I mean, this is a well-coached team that has a lot of depth there on the offensive side, the backfield too, right?
Yeah, incredibly well-coached team. And here's the thing. Like, you sound like an idiot when you say they're the best 0-5 team in America. But then you look, and many teams would quit. They didn't quit. They scored with 40 seconds to go thinking they were tying the game to go to overtime, and they miss a dadgum inch. They get an extra point blocked. You know, so they're not quitting. They're continuing to play, and they're going to come in here, and they're going to give us their best shot. And we've got to have our punches ready to be thrown if we want to get this W this weekend.
Defensively, with him at the helm, I know I read that he had moved more to a standard 4-3.
Yeah, which is what he was when he was a head coach in Atlanta, what he was when he was a head coach in Seattle. And I worked with Ed Donato before, who was his defensive coordinator at both stops. And then when he went to UCLA and was a head coach, he was more of a 3-4, two-gapping front. But he's always been involved in that defensive side of the ball. Obviously, we all know his dad, Jim Mora Sr., and some of the great sound bites he's made through the years. But, look, this is a great football coach that absolutely knows what he wants to do and how he wants to do it. We're going to, again, have to earn everything. Very pro-style on both sides of the ball.
And good running game. Victor Rosa back there, Devontae Houston. The quarterback, Roberson, Penn State transfer, was injured last year. But now this year he's come on and almost a 60% passer.
Yeah, and like Chris, like Coach Smith said, he and Chris Conte went to high school together. They're really good friends. So that's going to be a good rivalry between them. He is a very athletic quarterback. But again, I talked to Conte today. Conte's like, he was always throw first. He doesn't want to be a runner, you know? And so it's interesting because he's affected the game some with his legs and the opportunities he's gotten this year.
Hey, Coach, thanks. I'll be talking tomorrow at the presser. Appreciate the time.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Dunleavy Family Head Football Coach for Rice Owls, Mike Blumgren. Thanks so much to everybody coming on out here. By the way, that preview brought to you by IBEW Local 716. International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers represents any and all electricians. Houston Gulf Coast area, IBEW Local 716. Lighting up Rice University and Houston over 100 years. Well, you can come next year, next year too, but you can come the next couple of weeks. We will not have shows the next couple of weeks, but we'll be back here in a few weeks. We got the off week next week, and then after that, we'll be hopefully flushing the UConn game after that, going on to the other one, Coach.
I'm trying yes,
to
sir.
Mix in your other analogies
no,
there.
That's right. It's a vicious cycle, but it's awesome.
Thanks, boss. Appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
That's Coach. Thanks to Walter here. Thanks to Clara back at the studio. Thanks to our guest, Mr. Pittsburgh Tough Coleman Coco. And thanks to the pride of McKinney and beyond, Play Wyatt. And thanks to Brian Smith as well. Have a great rest of this night. God bless. Go Owls. Rice fight. We'll be talking to Saturday, the Owls and the Huskies there. This has been the Mike Blumgren Show, live from Acme Oyster House from Learfield.
On the Rice Sports Network from Learfield, you've been listening to the Mike Blumgren Show, live from Acme Oyster House. Acme Oyster House, the best little oyster house in Texas. Tonight's show was brought to you by The Parking Spot. The Parking Spot, we have airport parking covered. Also by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 716, lighting up Rice University in Houston for over 100 years. The preceding has been a Learfield presentation of the Rice Sports Network.